Every application will have some degree of AI. And some applications will be dominantly AI, some applications will be more programmed.
Well, I'm happy to welcome Joseph Sirosh from Microsoft. You are the Corporate Vice President and CTO of AI.
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us in our AI Summit interview series. Really happy to have you.
Pleasure to be here, Ben.
Microsoft has really, it seems like they've put a slogan around their AI space, which is AI for good.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit about that? What's that all about?
Microsoft's slogan overall is empowerment. Right. We believe in empowering others because people build on the platforms we create and build amazing things on top of them, right? So we believe AI can actually be a very powerful force in this economy for good. And let me give you a few examples.
Please.
You know, today I spoke about a prosthetic arm that can see.
Oh, neat.
Okay. I mean, so the arm has a camera. And a camera, when you bring it close to an object, it recognizes what that object is. And then a cloud AI service tells what fingers to move to grasp that precisely, right?
I love it.
That's very powerful. And the magic, by the way, is in the cloud AI service. There, it detects the object, understands what that object is, calculates what the right grip should be, and executes that. And then it's customizable. You can train it and set it up the way you want. You can change it to different environments. Other people could give you skills. Now imagine if you could 3D print cheap prosthetics. You could connect it to a cloud service. So the cloud service could control the behavior of it.
Right.
You don't have to painfully interface it with your body. I mean, today's prosthetics, just getting that to work with you and you training your own muscles, etc., to operate that, very difficult, very painful. You took all of that away. Now, to a cloud AI service, you say, oh, I want to grasp that object. It recognizes that object and you grasp it. And you can take that picture to almost every kind of prosthetic device, not just an arm.
Right.
You know, it could be anything that is assisting you.
So how does Microsoft do this? So you sponsored this competition, two undergraduates built this system for, you know, $100.
Correct.
Where do you go from there?
We then show how the platform can be used by all of these kinds of other device makers.
Mm-hmm.
And so now it's really up to the end device makers and the application makers and software makers to leverage that and build on top of it.
Okay.
So we are creating that enabling technology that opens up all of these possibilities.
How big is the team that you have that's under you and working on all these exciting things?
Well, so Microsoft has thousands of people working on AI and machine learning, and then even more thousands of engineers building these platforms. So it's actually now a company-wide effort. And AI, in many ways, is becoming part of software, right? It's not, now it's almost as though you shouldn't consider it as a separate thing at all. There's programmed intelligence from traditional software, and there is artificial intelligence, which learns from data. And both coexist, and every software application will be an AI application as well.
So if we look, you know, 2 years into the future, 5 years into the future, finish this sentence. Microsoft is a blank company.
Microsoft is a cloud and AI company.
Cloud and AI
and,
company.
Yeah, and every application will have some degree of AI.
So one of the things that I think is difficult about AI is it's if it's done right, it's completely intangible and you know, it's a ghost in the background, right? How do you communicate that to both your clients and also help them communicate to their customers, this idea that when done correctly, it's invisible?
Right. And you know, by the way, that's true about software as well. Now, you know, you and I are having a conversation, even though it's with microphones and things, there's a tremendous amount of software, recording the video, processing the video,
right.
Coding the video,
right.
All sorts of things, right?
Right.
You're absolutely right that powerful technologies like this just disappear into the background. There is a famous quote by Mark Weisner about this, right?
Right, technology. Right.
It's, just, it's like, we don't see electricity. There's nothing sparking in front of our eyes, right?
Right,
yeah.
Right.
The same way with AI, that all of these powerful technologies just go into our systems. The systems around us become adaptable, responsive, learning, far more tailored to our preferences, and able to provide magical interactions.
So I like the way that that Microsoft has placed this focus on AI for good. How hard is it to be a market leader, a huge company like Microsoft, in a space where there are so many up-and-coming companies that are trying to do very different things? You have to really set the standard. I mean, is that a hard position to be in, or is it the best position to be in?
Well, we have always been in that position. And what we are able to do is be a really good partner. And Microsoft partners with everyone. Like, for example, we have a great partnership with Cognizant. We have an amazing partnership where we bring our platform technology, and Cognizant brings a lot of domain expertise and the ability to really implement these solutions in these verticals together. And that's an amazing marriage made in heaven. And the thing about Microsoft is, in some ways, we are just about empowering everybody else. So it's a non-threatening position in many ways. I mean, certain other companies that have clouds, et cetera, they are, you know, very strong in certain businesses and encroaching into one business after another in many ways that are threatening. And instead, we are about being a platform that others build on.